I'm Patti from Pretty Simple Gardens, and now that spring has sprung, we are going to talk about the correct techniques for mulching, and also my arch nemesis, the awful tree volcano. I'm sure you've seen them everywhere, and here, let me give you some examples. Here in this beautiful tree, their mulch is way too high up the tree. The goal is to have the mulch just come right up to the tree flare. That's not happening here. So what we're going to do is pull the mulch away. And we're going to do our very best to find that tree flare and get this tree taken care of. So over mulching is also really bad for bushes and perennials. So as you can see, this bush is struggling as well. Because there's too much mulch up and in it. We really want to get the mulch away from the base of the plants. Same with these poor perennials. In this example, this poor perennial can hardly rear its little head out of the ground. The goal is to have the mulch come up to the plant, but not actually touching the plant. Much better. So one of the things I did today is I pulled a lot of the mulch away from this tree. It previously was up to here, and you can see how this tree is a little rotted. You can also notice these roots up coming up this direction. That's not where we want roots to go, because the more you mound the mulch, the roots go up instead of down. And this is not healthy for the tree. So I'm going to use my brand new Hori Hori tool from Duluth Trading, and we're going to cut these roots off. I'm going to go all around and get rid of these, because we don't want these dried out roots connected to the plant. So I'll go around and do that to the entire tree. We're getting closer to the root flare here. It's looking better. Okay. So this beautiful tree, the tree volcano, is up to about here. So I've pulled it away and it's pretty mounded. So all I'm going to do is to clear as much as I can. If you want to get professionals in to use an air compressor to really clear it out, that's always a good idea as well. But we're going to add the mulch to help retain water, but we're keeping it 2 to 3 inches away from the base of the tree. So we do want the mulch to help keep moisture in the ground. So the moisture, when it rains, will come right down the tree and go right down to the roots. So that's a good thing. And then this nice mulch will help to protect protect the moisture, and will also help balance out temperature from and protecting the ground and the roots from heat and from cold. So now these beautiful perennials, these little daylilies, I love them. But again, the mulch is a little too close, so we're just going to spread it out a bit. And that does two things. It gives the rain a chance to get into the ground. It also allows the plant to spread a little bit. So if you want your plants to get bigger, you need to move the mulch away so they have somewhere to, some way to actually pop up through, and they'll do much, much better. My favorite way to mulch is to first use organic matter. So I actually have some leaves. So what I do at home is I leave my leaves from the fall in the garden. In the spring, I actually just go and I crunch them up real good. And then I will lightly cover those leaves with mulch. And that will be my mulch for the season. Personally, I don't like it quite so thick because I want my plants to spread and I like seeds to drop and I'm going to throw seeds in. So I wouldn't use this much. But if you're really trying to keep weeds down, then of course a nice thick layer of mulch will do that. But not too thick because again, you're not trying to water the mulch, you're trying to water the roots of the plant. So you want the water to be able to get down in. So if it's too thick, it'll just water the mulch. So you don't want it too thick, no more than an inch or two. I'm Patti from Pretty Simple Gardens. Thanks for joining me today. Happy gardening!